Welcome to part three of my Swift Playgrounds Rockets Are Fun build series. In this video, I'm going to be adding the attack to our rocket ship, so we'll be able to fire projectiles to help defend ourselves once we have enemies. Let's jump into Swift Playgrounds. The way I'm going to do this is another one of those situations where I'm going to need to pass data between SpriteKit into the SwiftUI view. And I'm going to have a button in that SwiftUI view that when tapped by the player, we'll fire our weapon. Let's set up the button first, and then we'll hook all the data transfer and interactions up next. Okay, so inside of our V stack, I'm going to create an H stack. Inside our H stack, we're going to have two buttons, the first of which we'll reveal today, the next of which we'll reveal in the next video. So get subscribed so that you see that. This one is going to have an action, and we will fill this out later. For now, we'll just print attack. And then label, and the label is going to contain a VStack, which will have an image, system name, light.daytime.fill. We are going to make this resizable, give it a frame, width of height of 40 by 40. Give it a rotation effect of dot degrees of 90 so that it is vertical, and give it a foreground color dot cyan. And then we are also going to give here, we're going to add a text. It's going to be basically our ammo count. For now, we'll just do 50. I'm just going to do padding 15 after this. So now for our button itself, we need to give that a little bit of a style. So we're going to do button style dot border prominent. This will allow us to see the border. And then we're going to do button border shape dot rounded rectangle foreground color dot cyan dot shadow cyan. And we'll do a radius of 10. Don't need that. Padding. Trailing is 15. Tint. Dot purple. That will do it for now. So then we're going to also add another button. This is going to be a mysterious button for now. So we'll just call this print question mark, and we'll do a question mark dot app dot fill, and this one doesn't, for now, doesn't need to be rotated. I don't know what that's going to do yet. Leave a comment below. Let me know what you think it should do. So we have our two buttons. Right now, they don't do anything when tapped, but they're there. So now we need to give, we need to pass some data through so that we can have them take effect. So inside of game data, we're going to need a published variable for attacking, and this is going to be a bool equals false. And we are also going to need a published variable for ammo, and that will be an int equals zero. And now we'll hop into game scene and hook up this logic. So we have an at binding private var attacking, which is a bool, and at binding private var for ammo, which is an int. And then we need to add those here. So we'll have attacking is a binding bool, and ammo is a binding int. And then here we need to give our default to attacking equals attacking and ammo equals ammo. So now we need to give ourselves a default ammo, which is 30, and we will default our attacking equals false. So now I'm going to create our fire attack function, which is just going to fire a projectile in the direction the rocket is currently facing at some velocity. So first, if our ammo is less than or equal to zero, we're going to return. We're out of ammo. We cannot fire a projectile. And then we're going to create a new projectile, which is a sprite node of color.yellow and a CG size of, let's do 10, width.height 10 by 10. And then we're going to do a projectile.position equals CG point. And this is going to be an X and a Y, where we're going to get the rocket.position.x and the rocket.position.y. And this one here is going to have, is actually going to be the rocket position.y plus rocket.size.height divided by 2. This is that. So now we're going to do projectile.physicsbody. Equals skphysicsbody rectangle of projectile.size. And then we're going to give our projectile a lifespan using sk action. So we're going to set up a weight and then a remove from parent. So let projectile life equals sk action dot weight for duration 0.75. Let projectile remove equals sk action dot remove from parent. And then this is going to be fire sequence equals sk action dot sequence, and it's going to contain projectile life and projectile remove. And then we're going to add our child, which is the projectile. We're going to give it an impulse, adjusted rotation equals rocket dot z rotation plus CG float dot pi divided by 2. Let dx equal 10 times the cosine of adjusted rotation. Let dy equal 10 times the sine of adjusted rotation. And our projectile is going to get an impulse. So the physics body, apply impulse CG vector, dx of dx, dy of dy. And we are, of course, also going to do projectile.run our fire sequence. And finally, we need to do ammo minus equals 1. So now we need a way to trigger our fire function. And that is going to happen inside of update. So in our update function, we're going to have something called if attacking is true, we will call fire attack. And we will then immediately set attacking to false. So we'll fire our attack when and only when attacking is true. And as soon as we fire that attack, we're going to set it to false. So now we need a way to toggle our attacking parameter. But if you remember, we set it up here at the top as a binding. And in game data, we have the ability to write to that. So that means in content view, we can change our action here from print attack to an action of game data dot attacking equals true. We also are going to need to set these up here at the top. We're going to need to make sure that we have these added. So we have attacking, which is a binding, is going to be game data dot attacking. And we have ammo, which is a binding, and that's game data dot ammo. And now the only other thing we need to do is inside of our text here, rather than say 50, we need to do GameData.ammo. So now if we test this out, we should be able to move around still. And as we fire, you can see we get our yellow projectile and our ammo goes down. And then as we get to zero, we can no longer do any firing. And that's a quick one. Next time I will be implementing the mystery button, see what that does. And we'll do some more stuff. I hope you're enjoying the series. Thank you again for watching. Bye for now.